be the boss. Paid the cost to be the boss. I paid the cost to be the boss. Look at me, you know what you see.
Yes, yes, you are now tuned into the CEO Row Experience. I am your boy, CEO Row, and today we got a special one, as always. You dig what I'm saying? But before I introduce my special guest, I would like to give a shout-out to Ron, a.k.a. Mobile Fun Drinks.
Yes, sir, let's get it.
For coming through and helping to make the experience an experience. You dig what I'm saying? Every show since Ron has been on the show, we create a drink, a signature drink in honor of our guests. You dig what I'm saying? We will let you know what that is in a minute. But again, I want to shout out my guy, Ron, a.k.a. Mobile Fun Drinks. Man, we've been going strong. We like 16, 17 then.
Hey, man. Thanks for having me again, man. I ain't keeping stats no more. As long as we undefeated, that's all I'm keeping.
No doubt, no doubt, no doubt. But getting back to my special guest, this person does it all, man. It's been a minute. I've been trying to get her in some shape, form, or fashion on one of my platforms, so that we can, you know, dig in a little deeper as to who this person is. I think she's really dope. But with no further ado, who do we have today?
I go by Marley the Great, okay. A.K.A. Marsae. That's actually my first name, though.
Okay. It's a pleasure to have you, Marsae, A.K.A. Marley the Great, on the show, man. It's definitely a pleasure. Let the people know where you're from. And what it is that you do. We can start from there.
I'm from all around Philly. Okay. Everywhere.
So you're from Philadelphia. You just...
Yeah.
All city.
I do music production, audio engineering. I'm an artist, songwriter, singer, drummer, chef. Do videography, photography. And I mean, wherever you would need me, I'm that person that'll try to fill that hole. If I don't know something, I'll basically learn it so I can fill the hole.
Yeah, man, you a bona fide hustler.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying?
Baby,
I wish
man.
I'd have met Come you on, first. Man. I wish I'd have met you first. man, we looking for a few good, you know, men over here in this situation. You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We need the
people around.
No doubt. We gonna definitely work. But with all those many hats that you wear, what was your first love?
My first love would have had to be playing the drums. I started playing when I was 4.
Okay.
I started playing in church, and I was a little girl, hiked my skirt up.
Okay.
I would always see different churches come and, you know, fellowship, and they had the drummers playing. I'm like, I want to do that. And one day they just let me do it, and I was like, little sticks was long, and I still remember it. It just was like nonstop.
Right.
Like from that point, I started doing marching band or a drill team.
Okay.
Playing the triplets, then went on to the quads, the quints, snare, jazz band and having band
okay.
and like all that. So it would have to be drums, like percussion. I think that's like the heart of
okay.
our people anyway.
No doubt. That's the pulse right there. I mean, the drums, man. The drums,
Ooh,
man.
That bounce.
You dig me? I think that's dope. You definitely gave us some detailed, a detailed description of, you know, your training in it.
Yeah.
I'm not just a drummer freelance. No, I started in the church, and then I went to the step with the drill team, and then I went to, you know, jazz. I think that's real dope because I like all of it. I remember when we were kids when we had the drill team. It's not really that much anymore. I know they have the dance teams.
Yeah.
But the drill with the drummers, I see them on the side asking for money, but
yeah.
I don't see them really marching down the street like they used
competitions,
to anymore.
Like, we used to go to competitions and stuff. I haven't even, like, honestly, I have a studio that's not too far. Like, I saw, like, some guys with some drums. And then people, like, but they was just going down the street just like a few people. It wasn't like back in the day. We used to have to go marching,
lines,
like we'd
right.
be like 2 miles at the end, and it'd be a competition with all the drill teams, and like,
part,
you know what I mean?
No doubt.
Yeah, that was a whole nother level. I don't know where that went.
Man, drummers, where y'all at, man? Drummers, come back out, man. We need you, man.
Drummers, we have one. Maybe that's something that we can look in the door.
I
know.
I actually know a lot of drummers. Like, it'd be like, I guess the whole getting like the community involved, the kids, and like you know. Basically making up the steps and all that stuff like that, that'd be the missing part. Because then you'll just have these drummers, but you won't have, like, the actual drill team. That's
the girls that are stepping in boots with the ballies on the front.
You know what? Hold on, what you got to do? What's up? Battle the drummers. Hey, forget the drill team.
Hey, that's something. Hey, but you know, we got to keep top secret stuff. You put it out
there. Man, you give them a recipe, they can't duplicate it.
I literally was going to say that. Like, I literally always say, like, you know, you could tell somebody a plan. If they don't have the drive to do it, they won't do it. They can't. They can't succeed at it. It's not their bad. You know what I mean? So.
I agree. Ryan, I mean, I see that you jumping into the situation, man. I would love for you to tell us what's the name of the signature drink that we got from Marsae, a.k.a. Marley the Great.
You already know. The name speaks for itself. The Great Marsae, peaches and apple. It's like brandy, so.
The Great Marsae.
Man, in fact, it's the 50th episode, so bro, we ain't waiting for the second seven. Yeah, get a bottle. Yeah, let's crack it open. Let's get it.
Yeah. We definitely want to give a big shout out to everybody again that helps to make the CEO Road experience, you know, an experience.
Oh, let me get you
an
icy one.
Let me get you a shout out to everyone that has been a guest previously on the CEO Road experience. We are definitely at our 50th episode.
Yeah.
And we're going strong. I would like to thank my guys in the back, of course, that helped to make this a situation as well, because without them, you know, you wouldn't be getting this production, man. It wouldn't look so fly. You dig what I'm saying? So again, I appreciate you guys, man. I love you guys, man. And we at 50, man. I see you at 100. At 100, we're gonna throw a party for the 100th show.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we're gonna throw a party for the 100th show. So we got Marsae the Great.
The Great Marsae.
The Great Marsae.
Apples and peaches.
Marsae, the Great Marsae.
Marsae. Like the town in France.
Yeah. Marsae.
The Great Marsae.
The Great Marsae.
Apples and peaches.
Apples and peaches.
It looked good. I mean, it's freezing. I'm but pretty sure
it's like it. You got to make sure you like it. Test, toast.
Well, you got to drink. You got to finish the drink before the end of the show for it to be named after you.
I mean, you should already know.
Yeah.
I'm a Pisces. So.
Well, let them know what we got in here, Brother Ram. What you put in here?
We got
apples and peaches.
Pretty much. That's she likes a brandy. So we got an apple and peach blend.
Mm. Yeah, that's good.
I know, baby. I know.
That's nice and smooth right there.
I think you want to punch your bro in the head, man.
You know, this nice drink with the amazing appetizers that Chef CEO will prepare for us, man. Yeah. You know, we got something.
Yeah, no doubt,
you.
Man. You know, the show must go on, man.
The show.
I had some lemon pepper and some buffalo wings for us, man, and some Hawaiian roll, man. You already know.
A little something.
I do apologize, Marsae, because I forgot you're a pescatarian.
Yeah, no, it's all good.
And I wouldn't have did that.
No, you're cool. It's all good.
But
it's all good.
Yeah, I apologize for that. We got you Next one, I'm gonna lay it out for you, because on this one I dropped the ball.
No, it's all good.
Like, but we got you. We got you with the peach and apple.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And this joint is definitely popping. Oh. And it's definitely chilled. Get your fruits. So you get your fruits in there. You need to get your fruits every day.
Just Tuesday. As Brother Ron would say, to stay hydrated, we got to stay
hydrated.
That
joint's smooth. Like,
yeah, because he said he created it for the person that smokes that's not really a drinker, correct?
Yes. So it's like a nice, put the fun back in your drink.
Put the fun back in your drink.
Yeah. Can't be mad when you drink that.
Mm-hmm. Not at all. Mm-hmm. I like that, John. Mm-hmm. Okay.
The Great Marsae. Marsae.
Marsae. Or Marley.
Yeah.
You can go Marley if Marley works for you. You dig me?
Like, even with that, though, like, most people knew me as Marley or Marley the Great. And that was prior to me becoming an artist.
Okay.
And I mean, that was my production name. That was my engineer name. And I mean, so once I decided to be an artist, it was like I had to separate the two. Because when I would walk up and, you know, say something to people, it's like, oh, yeah, this is my song. The first thing they listening to is like the beat. And they were like, oh, you made this beat? Who the artist? Like midway through the song, I'm like, oh, who that? And I'm like, that's me. And they're like, wait, huh? And it's like, okay, let me separate the two. To the point where it got to a point where people was like, well, who is Marley and who is Marsae? And I'm like, actually, Marsae is my first name. Okay. You know what I mean? Marley was a given name that somebody gave me. Shout out to Slim Bird. And it was like, yeah, but I had to do that just to make it make sense. So, but people call me both. What's some up? People still don't get it. Some people will be like, well, Marley Marsae. Like,
well, they're going to get it. You know what I'm saying? They're going to get it. They're going to tune into the CEO Road. And they're going to understand that Marley is great, is the great. You dig me? Speaking of artists, man, you are a dope artist.
Thank you.
Are on the beam. You dig me? You have a vibe to you. I like vibes. That's what it is with me. It's a vibe. Can I tune in, tap in with it, and rock out? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And definitely you are one of those artists that I feel that anyone watching this needs to tap in, So if they would like to tap into your music or tap into your movement, where could they find you at, Marley?
Marsae, 2 underscores everywhere.
Copy.
I mean, everywhere.
Everywhere.
You gotta have a universal, man.
No doubt. Tap in, man. She's real dope. Music,
thank you. I appreciate
again,
it.
Is a vibe, man. You're coming off of two performance weekend. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yeah, man. So shouts out to the Cancer Bash. Shouts. Happy birthday to all the cancers. Happy birthday to my bro, EA.
Yeah.
Shouts out to Glockaware. You know what I'm saying? And then you also did the Indie Fest.
Yes.
That was yesterday.
At the Fire, yep. That joint was chill. Like, both of them actually was good joints. I'll say, it was crazy at EA joint.
Okay.
Shorties was wild. They did not care. They was just right. You know who you are, and I hope you see this.
Yeah.
You're wild as shit, man.
Yeah.
Yo.
Wow.
Like, no, it's dead ass. Like, as soon as we got up the stage, because, like, my partner is also my DJ.
Mm-hmm.
So as soon as we get up the stage, they just start going crazy. It was like, oh, shit. I was like, damn.
Yeah.
But it was fun time.
They got a little bit beside themselves. You might have to get a little bit of us.
It's okay.
I appreciate it. And make a way for you as you make your way off stage. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
You gotta let some things happen naturally, ain't nothing.
Hey, it is what it is. Don't force it. You never know.
That part.
Yeah, don't force it.
But yeah, Indie John was chilling. It was a few of us there. Ghetto Reese was in the building.
Shouts out to my little cuz Ghetto Reese, man. He does his thing. Yeah.
Shelliano burnt it down.
Shelliano.
I mean.
Yeah.
Primo. I don't know if you.
Yeah, Young Boy.
Yeah.
Little Giant
yeah.
Entertainment. Yeah, that's my guy.
Body that joint.
Yeah, that's like, my guy. Yeah, I got to get him on here. Work on here. So when I see you guys, man, I'm going to tap in. I got to get you on here, fit you into the schedule so we can interview, man.
Yeah, everybody
Primo's
helped.
Primo's a dope youngin'.
It was, a few more people in that joint. Everybody definitely held that joint down. I mean, so it was fun. And it's always fun, with some Glockaware shit. They had the G-Bus out there and all that.
Okay.
I mean,
how about Glockaware? Shouts out to Glockaware.
Yeah.
Make sure you tune in every motherfucking fly day from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. Check out the fly girls from 3 to 4 p.m. Shouts out to my sis. She's one of the fly girls. You dig what I'm saying? Shouts out to Paulie. Shouts out Paulie Baby. Shouts out to Lucci Tote. Shouts out to Chick with the Juices.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Every fly day, 3 to 4. You got my sisters, the fly girls. And then from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m., you got us, the fly boys. You got Grandma Nas Nah, you got Kane Black, and you got, the flyest one, Rich Poe, man, the logo. Make sure you tap in. You can also slide through there if you would like to kick it. It is one of the flyest happy hours in the world. You dig what I'm saying? Good vibes, BYOB, 420 friendly. You feel what I'm saying? So shouts out to the gang. You know what I mean? Marley, what does it for you as far as performing is concerned?
I guess for me, it was... Initially, it started off with being a person that people was like, you can't do that. You're like the drummer. You're in the background. You're this lesbian or dyke or whatever. You know what I'm saying? So people, so to me, it was like, okay, you had the stigma of me. Let me show you what I could do.
Because they said you couldn't do
it.
Made you want to do it even more. Took time
because
we got to craft it and,
Yeah. I mean, it definitely, I can say that, I've been performing for a while, but taking it, serious as an artist, it was like, okay. It really was just going against the grain because everybody tried to get me to say, hey, you can write this song for this person or that song would be dope for this person. Trying to figure out where to put my sound at. And it's like, no, I do this job. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, no doubt. Me. Clap
that up.
Yeah.
I don't know what to say to do it. I'm clapping myself on that.
Yeah.
But no, that's it. That's really it. Well, I only say that's really it. That was the beginning. Then it just became enjoying music, enjoying frequency. You get what I'm saying? Even introducing love music because we got away from that shit. Everybody it's in a certain space where it's just kill and have some sex with a bunch of different random people, do
and
a bunch of different drugs and then kill somebody.
Yeah.
And it's like, yo, we got away from love and it needs to be brought back. Yeah. You know what I mean? That was it for me.
Yeah.
I mean,
no doubt, man. I truly believe in that. We definitely need to get back to the love, compassion, common courtesy, and most importantly, as you stated, the love for the culture.
Yeah.
The love for one another. We will, I believe, get back to that. It's going to get back.
It's
it's a cycle. It's just sad that we had to go through this killing field time You know what I mean? But hopefully we're learning from it, and I feel that we are starting to move away from it.
Yeah. I mean, people get sick of it. It's like, it's, I don't know, even down to like the youngins, like people getting, they just becoming sick of it. It was like a video on the gram of this guy in his cell, and like bullets rolled in on him, and you know what I mean, did what they did to him.
Right.
And drug him down a whole block. Like, it wasn't about nothing, and it wasn't no guards or nobody to come help, and it just was like, he was done, though. Boy, I don't even know. Boy, still hairy, unalive. You get what I'm saying? But right. They had the whole thing filmed. Right. A lot of these kids don't know that's what jail looks like in cases. Not all the time, but that's what it looks like. So right. Y'all come in there thinking y'all tough because the rappers talking about this in their songs, and y'all doing all this blicky and stuff, then y'all get to prison. And it's completely different from the street life that you saw or that you thought you were seeing because you wasn't seeing it. You get what I'm saying?
It's, we had a saying back in the day, man, you don't realize shit real until shit get dark.
Facts.
You know what I mean? Like, you know, you running around, you might be doing your little reckless shit. You might be getting away from it. You ain't get caught. But when you get caught and you have to really face certain consequences and certain scenarios, are you really built for the bullshit that you think that you'd be down with or you want to be a part of?
And, so I'm not.
You know, and that's what it is, man. It's not cut for everybody. And a lot of dudes don't really understand that it's not for them until they go through that.
Yeah, and that's until it's over.
Too late. Like, you know what I mean? Until it's too late, they realize, like, yeah, I shouldn't have been playing this game. This is not the game for me. Nobody's riding for me. No, yeah. I'm by myself. You know, and now you look at it like it's too late. How am I going to get out of this?
Man.
You feel me? For those that are not as quicker than, you know, the average bear,
yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? Like, how do I get out of this now? Now things is too thick, rather, excuse me. Life and death. How do I get out of this? You know what I mean? And sometimes you can't.
It's some wicked shit. Like,
yeah, it's definitely. It's jail is not for the faint of heart. It's, you know, it's not for the faint of heart. It's not for the weak.
It's not at all.
It is really, to be honest, it's savage.
Yeah.
It's savage. And now you can add discipline in it because everybody's not the same. You can add the reform, you know, your programming and things of that nature. You know, you go in, some people want to change. I don't want to continue to be a savage.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I was that person. I mean, my birthday is March 10th, like I said, Pisces gang. Mm-hmm. Shout out to all the Cancers, too. You know, we wore the signs and we in the building. If y'all ain't here, we in here. But I'm definitely a Pisces. Mm-hmm. I walked off of 10 years parole mm-hmm. on my birthday this year. You know what I mean? Like, on my birthday. So it was like, that was like the best feeling. I never really talk about that side of my life. Like, really, I'd be like, yeah, shit was crazy back then. But I don't really go on into that. Right. So I'm one of those people that went to prison. And my experience wasn't everybody's experience, to be honest. Like, right. My experience was, I'm not glorifying in any kind of way, but I am a lesbian. Right. So that says enough about prison.
I mean,
you get what I'm saying? So it's like kind of different in those
rounds. I'm really confident. I mean, listen, if I could be in lockdown and it's a bunch of women, I'd be with it too. I'm a lesbian too.
To that.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a lesbian too. You know what I'm saying? I'm a lesbian. I love women.
No, but it was like,
we like the same stuff.
It was like, it was an eye opener because I was doing wild ass shit. I was super.
It slowed you down, right?
That shit sat me the fuck down.
No doubt.
3 years. I was up Muncie. I had to go upstate. Okay. Like that shit, I was up State Road for like 3 months. That was the longest time I spent up there. I spent that time out and away from here where it take 5 hours to get there, so ain't nobody coming to visit you. But I didn't want people to visit me because it was like, I didn't want to have to see the people leave, and then I got to go back to doing jail. It's a mental institution. You know what I mean? When you in there, you wake up in the cell, and you're looking at them lights, and they bright as shit while you sleep. And the motherfucker, like, you look down, it's cold as shit. You got this wool blanket.
Listen, like I said, all right, so, well, I was kind of already, I'm not going to say, I've been and walked a lot of many different paths.
Yeah.
But I have a military background. I'm what they would almost say is like a military brat. So growing up, I was disciplined at a very young age and understood and had a lot of responsibility and accountability at a very young age. And it kind of prepared me. Not saying I should have went that route, but because I went, I was already prepared. I was a man. I kind of went late in life anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah, it sat me down too, Molly.
Yeah, like a motherfucker. I wouldn't even. I
was moving fast too, babe.
It sounds cliche to say,
but it sat me
the
fuck down. You know, I had to learn. Like, look, hey, is this what you want? Is this what you want?
That's it.
That's not what I want. I don't want that. I don't want to wake up on somebody else's accord and do what, you know, somebody else wants me to do when they want me to do it.
But these youngins don't know
my
that.
My freedom is everything. I'm paramount. I'm revolutionary all day.
Yeah. They got to know that that joint is not like this. Yo, that shit is a weird zoo. And it becomes, the further up you go, the more time you get, it becomes literally like a mental mind fuck if you're not strong enough to be able to hold yourself in those times. Like, going up State Road, that is nothing compared to going upstate or doing some federal shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a whole nother ball game. You go up, yo, when I went up there, as soon as you get on Muncie, they got all these, like, cottage houses. They got two prisons that the prisoners had built at that time when I was up there. But all of the rest is like, look like little cottages. This bitch is walking dogs.
Right.
This bitch is cutting grass. And I'm like, wait, what the fuck? Like, my brain was, because I just was up, I was up there for upstate road for 3 months, and I was by myself. I was in the hole by myself. Everybody thought I was a murderer, by the way, because I didn't have no cellie, but I was state property, so I couldn't be with the county inmates. Bitches used to be sliding those in my door, who did you kill? And I need to know, like, I ain't fucking kill nobody. Like, what the fuck? But, like, being in that space of being by myself, even when I came out to exercise, as they say, like, I had the little, the chains and all that shit on. Everybody just watching me like, yo, who you kill? Like, I don't know why everybody thought I was a murderer, but they just kept saying, who you kill? Who you kill? I'd just be like, yo, I didn't even kill nobody. You go up there and bitches is cutting grass and mowing the lawn and, like, all this shit. And I just was like, what is this place? Right. I was like, what the fuck? This bitch got a golden retriever? How the fuck this bitch? But when you in jail for more than 5 years, you can get the program. You know what I'm saying? Like, well, you know what I mean? But that shit was a mental game that made me say when I came home, I don't want to do that shit. That shit was dumb.
That shit went. No doubt. But I appreciate you busting it up, Marley. I appreciate you coming through the CEO Row Experience and kicking it with us. We got to go pay some bills. We'll be right back with more Marley the Great on the CEO Row Experience.
Let's get it.
Breakfast in the morning, I'm a dinner at night. Grab your luggage, drop that burger, we about to catch a flight. Over time, I put the work and get her whatever she likes. I can't help but spoil her, she helped me change my life. I swear, I adore her, she my ride or die. Hey, we out, let's make a movie, let me see it, huh? These other women wanna be little mama, but I ain't creeping, I believe in karma. Niggas be mad when my position wanna be me, don't he? Just keep your distance, I keep the chopstick like I'm Benny Hunters. Baby rolling, stay with the mobstick, she don't play about me either. Greet me at the door, t-shirt, panties like Adina. Take it off and show me what you're made of. Like some covers, cut you cause I wanna. These other girls ain't you, they can't do what you do. All night, just us two. Hardcore is December, but I'm yelling timber cause I'm falling. I know that I play sometimes, but girl, I'm all in. I'm not here to waste your time, no, I ain't front. I can hear your body calling for me. The moans and the screams and the shaking your knees, babe. I'ma eat it all over the dinner table, and you gon' bust it open cause it's what it's made. You dripping through your drawers. Show me where you're made. I need love, I need love, I need loving from you. Kissing, hugging, and touching, and rubbing on you. Got me writing love songs about you.
Hey yo, no auto-tune for this one. What I say? I said I run this shit like relay.
Watch me go.
In the game, I'm reminding them of EA. Dash man from the South of City in the B-State. They fuck with me cause I ran from the GA to the B.
I
said I run this shit like relay.
Watch me go.
Tell a DJ gone, put this shit on replay.
Who I be?
Dash man raised in the city of the cheese steak.
Hey,
they
yo,
fuck with me cause I ran from the GA to the P.
From GA to PA, that's the P state to the cheese steak. See, I can't be no cheapskate. I can't go on cheap dates. I fuck with bad bitches. We ball out like who on a sweepstakes. That dash made my flow crazy. About to call my go baby. That's greatest of all those baby. I just tell her go baby. She might already know baby. Cause she seen her already know lately. I put it in her mouth so she might make it grow baby. Okay, okay, calm down, man, it's nothing to see. I hear a beat, I kill a beat, man, it's nothing to me. If you look a little close, I'm who they wantin' to be. You can come with 10 bad bitches, still ain't fuckin' with me. Okay, now check it, come on and crowd around if you looking for a blessing. I gotta hit shorty now, I done put her on my checklist. After I dick her down, she make a nigga breakfast. But I don't just sit around, I'm looking for an exit. I said I run this shit like relay.
Watch me go.
In the game, I'm reminding them of EA.
Who I
Dash
be?
Man from the South of City in the B-State. They fuck with me cause I ran from the GA to the P.
I said
I run this shit like relay.
Watch me go.
Tell a DJ gone, put this shit on replay.
Who I be?
Dash man raised in the city of the cheesesteak. They fuck with me cause I ran from the GA to the P.
Verse two, I'm about to go in early like a curfew. Shorty give me that Urkel, then throw that ass in the circle. That's your bitch, you can have it back, I ain't taking that bitch personal.
Hey,
I'm Dash Man, yep, I'm that man.
Yeah.
She thinks she about to stay the night, that's a bad plan.
A bad
she
plan.
Think I'm about to get an Uber, this ain't that man.
Go.
She need a ride, shorty better call a hack man. By now, y'all should know though, that I kick that shit like a dojo.
Yeah.
She throwing that shit, I'm pulling it back, I call that little bitch JoJo. I told her don't come solo, gotta bring a chick for my brodo. She said I ain't got no friends, I said uh-uh, bitch, that's no-no. Now check it, come on and crowd around if you looking for a blessing. I gotta hit shorty now, I don't put her on my checklist. After I dick her down, she make a nigga breakfast. But I don't just sit around, I'm looking for an exit.
I said I run this shit like relay.
Watch me go.
In the game, I'm reminding them of EA.
Who I be?
Dash man from the South of City in the B-State. They fuck with me cause I ran from the GA to the P.
I said
I run this shit like relay.
Watch me go.
Tell a DJ gone, put this shit on replay.
Who I be?
Dash man raised in the city of the cheesesteak. They fuck with me cause I ran from the GA to the P.
Breezy Rosale.
Breezy Ro, Breezy Ro, Breezy
Ro.
It really do feel different these days, man. It's like
do it.
That morning dew, that air just do something to you, man.
Like what?
Felt this way in years. I feel like life is really putting me down to the basics. I feel like Tom Holland and Spider-Man.
I'ma blow up just like I planned it. We about to fall, touchdown. No AJ Brown, nigga, I ran it. Got everybody screaming in panic. One day I'ma be on TV. You can find me by flipping through channels. They always call me a square and I wore well, so I put on that flannel. Life is a hill bike ride. You just gotta learn to grab by the handles. Be okay with yourself, never worry about how you finna grab it with mantles. Every locked door got a key. You just gotta take time to find a piano. I wrote patience just so I can lead all y'all by example. Yeah, fold on my wave like a castaway. Pull one out, fold as that pass away. Calling them bit pull up. Calling them bit pull up right away. You cannot run all on my parade. Flow with the umbrella. Hop in my shit, it's a rap, no bubble.
Nah,
surprise by my product, the pack is subtle. You ain't underrated, you lack the hustle. Trim all the fat and stack the muscle. I don't know if I got 20/20, but I know that my vision is stuck on tunnel. No matter if you trip or stumble, just remember, take it on the chin like stubble. I'm blooming in the concrete jungle where they steady shooting cause they scared to rumble. They peeling your top bad like they snatching frontals. I don't want no trouble. I just stay out the way, do my own thing, everyone befuddle. How it come from that place, get to that stage and remain humble. I struggle with lows, rolling it up and I'm letting it go with the smoke.
Yeah.
Floating on all of my hopes, thinking that one day I'll be able to travel the globe with music I wrote. Rich in spirit and I'm going for broke. I just wanna be example for those, feeling different, thinking that they roll clothes. You just gotta demolish up to goals. Nothing gonna hold you back except yourself. You just gotta let that other shit go. Take the time to understand who you are. By doing that, you'll discover your role. Stick to the script like a permanent marker. Act important, you'll be memorable. Wave gonna hit like a levee, them bro. I finna drown while watching me float. Float,
float. Fold on my wave like a castaway. Pour one out for that passed away. Calling in big pull up. Float, float, float. Calling in big pull up right away. You cannot run all on my parade. Float with the umbrella. Yo, shout out to Janae Monae and her titties. Woo! Gone.
And we're back with more of the CEO Row Experience. I got my special guest, Marley the Great, a.k.a. Marsae, on the panel. You already know, kicking it with me. I appreciate you coming. You already know.
Hell yeah.
I want to know, what are your pet peeves when creating music?
Making beats, I don't like for artists to kind of be like over my ear trying to either coach me on making a beat, or when I'm writing, people like kind of like, What you got? That shit burns me. It grinds my gears. You gotta stay. Give a creative their space, you know?
I think that's a good sign. Give a creative their space.
Yeah.
We might gotta copyright that. Give a creative their space.
Like, especially making beats. Like, you got, if rappers in the room, of course, I get it. Cause you got, I mean, you hear
you
it.
You wanna vibe and,
then start rapping and you're like, listen to what I got. And it's like, the same way that you write, I'm making this beat. So it's like, I'm focused on this. You know what I mean? Versus it just being like, you trying to, imagine me trying to talk to you the whole time while you trying to write your bars. I'm just like, yeah, because when I said, I thought, it, like, that's, you know, it's the craziest thing, but.
Right. So, I mean, like, so they, I've been in some sessions. I'm not going to lie. I haven't seen that, but, you know, I haven't been in a lot. But, you know, basically to have someone say, yo, listen to what I got before. I mean, I would say get in the booth first. Let me hear what it, and then we can go from there. Rather than you come, I mean, unless I'm helping you write it, am I getting credit for writing your?
No, because, like, you got to think about it, like actually building the beat, like, they already start, I don't know why, I don't know if it's just, like, I know it happened with a lot of producers that I know, though, but, like, they sitting there, they listening to it, they already got the tempo playing, you added things, by the time I'm still building it, by the time I get halfway through, they're like, yo, I got a whole song to this joint already, and it's like, I don't want to stop.
I got and, you, because that'll stop your process.
Yeah, it's like, it's going to limit me to what they're doing, and they might not even be saying no shit that I even want on this beat.
Right. Like, the artist, chill the fuck out, man. You know, come in, roll up something, smoke it before you can, you know, you get
in
there.
You can write your song. Or write, you know, get your little bars together. But the same way you write your song, you know, it's like the
nobody was bothering you, right?
Yeah, no, they ain't
Don't bother the producer. Don't fuck with the producer.
No, let them do their thing.
Let the producer do what they do. I see you finished your drink.
Yeah, I told you, I'm going to keep saying that till you get it. I'm a fish. Like, I drink like a fish. Like, I'm not an alcoholic, but I drink like a fish. Like, it's nothing to me, for real.
That's your vice.
Yeah, it's true.
I'm more 420 friendly. I like a nice drink.
I be too kind.
I really like a mobile fun drink.
Yeah, that joint definitely got me where I'm supposed to be.
No doubt, man. Shouts out to my man Ron. He already
knows. It was delicious at the same time. Like, it wasn't hard to drink, or, you know what I mean? But that's what you do. That's not my first encounter with your beverages, and they always get you where you're going. And M. Jones is definitely bomb.com.
Oh, thank you. Appreciate it.
Yeah, that joint's bomb.com. God, you're good
for you. You shake it. Food, I gotta make it special.
Ronnie.
Yes.
In effect, baby. I appreciate you. This is really good. I'm trying to get the apple. That's where I want. I don't want the juice to dribble down my chin. I'm trying to get an apple out, but I'm going to chill. I'm going to have to drink it down and get it out. You feel me? I appreciate it. Yeah, man. Mobile Fun Drinks, man. Let them know where they can find you at, bro.
You can find me on all major platforms at Mobile Fun Drinks. Definitely can find me every Monday and Wednesday, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. on the CEO World Experience, man. Come on out, man. Catch this experience.
Yeah, no doubt. Every Monday and Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m., live studio audience, you can come and you can see a live taping of my show. We welcome it. We have, you know, some appetizers, some snacks, and, you know, Mobile Fun Drinks is in the building. You feel me? And then you also catch the experience, which is the most important part. Mm-hmm. So, you know, again, check us out. If you're not doing nothing, come through, DM me at CEORO Experience on IG for the address.
Don't miss out on this experience, man.
Don't miss out on the experience. You're rocking with the best. Come and get the
experience. And come network, man. You know, it's the shit. Get some movers in here, man. You got to come network, man.
No doubt. No doubt. That's what we got to do. Speaking of networking, who would you like to network with? Who would you like to collab with?
Wow, that's a crazy joint. It would probably have to be, I feel like Kanye would be fun I feel like he'd be funny shit to do some shit with. Probably like Jazzy. I don't know if you ever heard of Shorty, but she's written like for Beyonce and Rihanna, like all these big people. My thing will be more so being with a producer than a particular artist per se.
Okay, all right, throw so yeah, throw.
If it was an artist, like if I had to pick, like those, they like all producers in a sense, but like if it was an artist, I'm gonna just go for the easy shit. I'm gonna do a song with fucking Drake. That shit gonna pop. Like what the fuck? It don't even matter what he's saying.
No, listen, I'm not mad at you. I like your vibe, and then if you could get with Drake, you know he gonna add to the vibe. You know we going platinum.
Yeah, you're supposed to always
just
know,
off the
feature
just
up.
Off the bootlickers. We going platinum.
Yeah, you're supposed to feature up. So fuck it, like why not? And
it
then
makes sense.
I'm just gonna go ham on that, y'all.
Copy that.
Drake, if you're watching, got a feature for you.
I would have said Wayne at the time, but
matter
of
fact, when you know when the show, you know. When the show, we're going to add Drake on the show, you know what I'm saying? So we can check in, so we can check out Marley the Great, man. You're definitely going to be performing at the end of the show, correct? Yeah. And what song are you going to be performing?
It might change. No, I think it's going to be Brainstorm.
Brainstorm.
It was the one that actually that you came that up to me and was like, yo, man.
You dope for that. You dope for that. Because I was going to ask. You dope for that because I was going to ask you to do that.
Yeah.
I didn't get a chance. You know, we were trying to get everything together. Yeah. But I appreciate you. If you are doing that, Brainstorm is a real dope joint. Heard it, didn't even know it was her, knew it was her. It was like, yeah, she murdered that joint.
That's how it normally happened, though. Most people be murdered like, that? I'm like, this is my song. I press play and they be like,
hey, you murdered that joint. That joint's dope. So I hope you do decide to do that.
I know I am. I'm definitely looking forward to it. Like, I specifically decided to do that because, I mean, I'm here and that's a song that you actually said, like, yo. Yeah,
that was dope. Give me a highlight moment of being a producer, highlight moment of being an artist.
Okay. Highlight moment of production was going to this like beat conference. Like they'll have like engineers and producers that have like networking events, and it might only be like a certain amount of people that they allow in. Mm-hmm. I mean, and going in there, and I was the only female, and it was for Meek Mill engineer Cruz. Mm-hmm. And you know, like I said, I'm an introvert at heart. You know what I mean? So I'm chilling off in the back. And they like, all right, we're going to do a pass the aux. And they passed the aux around the room. And like I said, I was the only female in there.
Right.
You know what I mean? And they got to a song that I had just did that night before. And like, the nigga gave me a standing ovation. Yeah. Like, and then sent me like a microphone that's worth a lot of bread. Like, and I wasn't even expecting none of that shit. I just came to the door one day, and he sent me this drawing, and it like right. with all these crazy plugins and all that shit, and you know he admired my music. So for somebody that was on that level, that's mixing like, you know, a Meek Mill record per se. You know what I mean, the sonic sound of his music is big. You know what I mean, it's in your face. It's a certain kind of industry sound.
Right.
For a motherfucker like that to hear my sound and my song and be like, yo.
And then bless you with a gift.
You know what I mean? And there's a whole room full of people playing songs. Like, all right, that's cool. But now I play my song. He jumped up out of seat, started clapping. I just was looking like, what the fuck? Like, I was high, too. Like I told you, I'd be chilling when I'm fucking fried. So I'm like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
So that, for that. And then for the artist, it would have to be playing the Met.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, the Met. I was there. Yeah. I came to the
and
Met.
And it's like, it's crazy because I was saying to my folks, shout out to Dub Dizza. We always talk
shout
about
out
like
to Dub Dizza.
The year before, like I can't wait to play the Met.
Right.
And then, you know, 2 years after, well, 2 years after my start, and I mean, it was like, damn, you on this big ass stage, this joint, this place,
the Trina 35
Trina
people, and,
Jim Jones, joint. Yeah. And I mean, even with that, like, shout out to EA, and I mean, of HipHopOnDeck.com, like he literally came to me and asked me to do it.
Right.
And I mean, it was like I wasn't even expecting it. It just was like, yo, I heard your shit. I think you hot as shit. Let me just put you in a space. So far, those have been like, you know, two of the biggest, you know, things from that really, like, you know, they pull at my heartstrings.
It's real dope moments, moments. So when you go in to create, is there certain essentials or certain things that you need? Like, for instance, you might need the coconut honey candle burning.
Oh, shit.
You know what I'm saying? Or you might got to get the Zaza. We not, no Reggie.
Oh, shit.
You might got to strictly have Zaza. You might want only alkaline water in your mix.
Damn.
You dig me? Or you might need the mobile fun drinks in your mix.
That would be my go-to. Like I said, I'm a drinker first. So the weed, depending on the mood that I'm trying to be in, I might get some, I might, you know, not require it, but with, you know, with liquor is always like a loosen you up a little bit. You know what I mean? Right. So it was like,
yeah,
to get the juices going. Yeah, for me, sometimes pre'd be like, oh, you can't say that. No, that ain't gonna sound right. No, that's like, I'll start second guessing shit. So I'll say that, you know.
So the liquor, you just need some liquor.
Yes!
And some, hell yeah.
Finally!
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Mobile fun drink.
Yeah, because you know we had a lot of non-alcoholic drinkers on here, respectfully.
Yeah. Respectfully, yeah. We've had a couple people that don't
get
drink.
Some drinkers up in this building. Yeah.
No, it's so like, yes. And like the company that I keep when I'm writing really can be the biggest part too. Like I'm typically a person where if I'm writing and everybody is like-minded creatives, it's easier to just bounce vibrationally off of each other. You get what I'm saying? Because we all going to feel something similar to this, but from our own lenses, you get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So those, just having that energy is like, that helps. But if it's like, I'm in a room full of like rappers and I'm writing like some love song shit, the vibe is different.
Right.
Cause they just trying to figure out a rap to the fucking R&B beat and this shit like a neo soul beat. The nigga trying to figure words out like, I'm like, hey, yo, like, but yeah.
That's funny.
Just some lick there and I'm cool. I'll be chilling.
Get some lick to open you up a little bit, get the vibes flowing and you in there.
Yeah.
We gonna come out with something diabolical.
At least, you know what I mean? At least.
So what can we look forward to from Marley the Great for the remainder of 2023?
Honestly.
And beyond.
Honestly, I would say as of right now, the mission is for me to get on, do more interviews where I'm actually speaking. Mm-hmm. Like versus it just being me playing my music and shit. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, and really, you know, let people know who I am. So mm-hmm. I ain't even... probably sound crazy from an artist perspective, but I'm not even worried about putting out any new records more so than actually making the connections and people being able to say, oh, that's Marsae. You get what I'm saying?
Happy that. Like,
do some shows.
That's actually understandable, man. And again, we appreciate having you here on the CEO Role Experience. And anytime you would like to come through and talk about anything or dropping something new that you want us to check out, we also can incorporate videos into our commercial segments. So if it's a new video you want to drop and all that good stuff, you want to come in and let it out on the CEO Role Experience, we're here for you.
That's a good job.
Yeah, man, we definitely appreciate you coming through and busting it up with us.
Hell yeah.
And I'm also looking forward to the performance. So don't go nowhere. When the interview ends, don't go anywhere. Marsae will be performing. Yeah. You dig what I'm saying? It's a don't want to miss. Yeah, it's a don't want to miss, man.
Yeah.
She got the Met under her belt. She's out here rocking. She's starting to do more performances. She's starting to do more interviews. Because, again, as we spoke, we want the people to get to know who you are.
Yeah.
And you know how deep you are. So when you're not doing all these different things, Marsae, you're not working, you're not chefing, you're not doing being a radio personality, you're not engineering, you're not being a significant other. What is it that you like to do to unwind or get in tune with Marsae?
Listen to music. I won't even just say music. It probably sound weird if you don't know what it is, but like binary beats. It's a frequency thing. Like even with the crystal things, like people see that and just think it's like it's because certain people were, you know, it's like really connected to this place. So for me, it's trying to ground myself and process everything and listening to, you know, certain set frequencies. Yeah, you know I mean, goes a long way, not only on from a metabolical standpoint, you know what I mean, but like a physical standpoint. A lot of people don't know frequencies can cure diseases. They blocked it, so they can't do it, but in the United States, but everywhere else, like places, that's why people have like terminal illnesses and go other places and come back without that shit.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I think we, you know, got away from that as a people because we adopted someone else's idea of how we supposed to be living. But so I'll bring myself back to just being grounded and probably listen to some frequencies. Might take some fucking shrooms.
Right. Yeah, because that was just some real deep shit you just took me on right there.
No, I'm all right with you.
No, I'm missing patience, but I'm like locked in and it was like, I'm.
You got to ground. You got to get
in tune. You're in tune. You got to get in tune with your energy.
Just with your higher self, with your presence. Get with the now. You get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Really enjoy where you are now. And even if you feel like I'm in a fucked up place, know that there's only four seasons, as well as, you know, it's a part of your journey. This journey ain't meant to go straight to the destination. That shit would be boring. Right. Like, really think about it. Like, you ain't had no origin story of how the shit started. You just was born.
Yeah.
Trillionaire.
Copy.
motherfuckers be, that's why they say, you know, money is the root of evil, because them motherfuckers never got the experience living. They never felt how it felt to fucking.
So that's why they do weird shit.
Get it from the muscle.
They don't know that shit. Like, yo, that shit make us, you know, the beings that we are. We experiencing this life in this timeline. And I mean, it's like, let me ground myself. And like I said, do some shrooms and shit, right? You know, roll the fuck back.
Hey, I ain't gonna lie, man. I had some shrooms recently, man. It's some real diabolical shit, man.
I remember.
I had some shrooms, man. It's real diabolical.
Y'all got a pocket for that, though.
Yeah, man, real diabolical shit, man. It ain't really my twist. I'm more of a smoker. You know what I mean? With the 420. You know what I'm saying? I'm not really with the edibles and all that.
Yeah, man. No,
but yeah, man, this had me zonked, man. You be zonked. You be talking, man. I probably won't hear you and shit. But you know what I mean?
You know why? You're... Okay, I don't want to take the show there.
No, you got it.
So the Earth is a living organism, right. And it has a certain frequency. The same way you're vibrating at a certain right. frequency. You get what I'm saying? So when you do something that like mushrooms, that literally they plug up these cords to mushrooms and they have a sound. It sounds like music that come out of them. Wow. They're living, like for real. You talking about popping that joint and putting that joint in your body? You hearing that joint frequency?
If I hear them biggest shit,
I know. Like I know.
When I put them joints,
I'll do like an eighth or a seventh for them joints and be chilling.
Yeah,
like,
that's good.
But it's something that is like for me. It helped ground me when I came, right. like coming home, couldn't get no job. That's a whole nother thing. But right. just getting into the spaces of like, okay, I need to create this experience.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? I need to experience these shit outside of this. Hard ass hood shit and dumb shit. Like,
You
don't want to fall into the anxiety lane. I understand.
Fuck no, you got
depression and all that good stuff. I understand completely, man.
That shit removes that shit.
And that's important that you say that. I want to touch on that as far as getting away from the things that you realize aren't good for you.
Yeah.
And one being your environment. Meaning if I stay in this environment, if I stay in this, you know, demographic, I have a better chance of making it or, you know, going in the direction that I want to go in. You feel me? So sometimes you have to really get away from and separate yourself and detach yourself from your norm.
The third dimensional realm that we live in and see through our eyes.
Yeah.
You got to detach from that sometimes because there's a system that was put, like everybody can say the Matrix.
Yeah.
It's literally the Monopoly game in real life. And they figured it out for us and told us what we was going to do. And I mean, and we just like falling in line with that shit. It's like, hold up, this is someone else's system. How would we be if this system wasn't in place? You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Because some people argue it creates control. Or not, I wouldn't say control. Some people argue it creates order, but it's more so of a controlled space. Yeah. You know what I mean?
It's like, a controlled order.
Yeah, but you can govern yourself,
yeah,
though.
You can, but you gotta. That's where you're breaking the matrix. You're breaking the system and understanding it. You can do it yourself.
It's dictatorship.
It's a lot has to do with
it. Making play by their rules in their game.
Yes.
Yeah. But you know, you don't have to fall victim to it if you govern and you govern your own shit well.
Yep.
You know what I mean? You gotta know how to play the game and use the system, you know what I mean?
Exactly, that's the part.
Exactly. Yep.
That's you know, if you haven't learned, that's the game that you should be learning.
Yeah.
You know.
But I'm just, you know, experiencing this reincarnation this time from a space of just learning love, gratitude, and not even being focused on like financial gain more so. And then, you know, getting to experience other beings, you know, that are all in their journey. We're not just here about just because, you get what I'm saying? Like, we crossed the paths for a significant reason, you get what I'm saying? It's like, I'm living in that.
You're walking in your greatness.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? This is a story, you get what I'm saying? So when you get up there, when you're ready to write your book, or when you're ready for your movie, you feel me?
My fucking ABD.
You know, you got something. Yeah, you got something to tell them. You got something to talk about. It's the same way how we sit there and watch how the movement was when Motown started.
Oh, yeah.
And things of that nature, how all those young artists and young kids was out there trying to do their thing, you dig me? And they put their name out there so they could be somebody later. So it's the same thing. You know, right now we're walking our greatness. We're making it. We're building the legacy.
Right in the path down every step, yo.
And that's real dope. And like I said, I've heard of you. How can I say, about 2 years now? No, two and a half?
Probably like 2.5.
Yeah, about 2.5. I saw you perform the first time the song was dope. I'm like, she's, it's because it's a vibe. It's like you're in tune. It's not like you trying too hard. You get what I'm saying? You're in tune, and I see it now. You're on it with the heavy crystals, the heavy and stuff. So I see now why it's a vibe. You know what I mean? And I you know, I appreciate that and keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you. I appreciate
you feel me?
That.
No doubt. You know, greatness, man.
We feel everything around us. Somebody walk in this room, the energy off, we all gonna feel that shit.
Right.
So it's like you gotta give that back.
And that's the thing. Yep. I'm learning to be a controller of the energies.
Mm-hmm. And you transmute that.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, yeah. I try to avoid, like, normally, you know, probably the younger me wouldn't have been as conscious.
Yeah,
but
facts,
if knowing, facts. Like, no, we're not going to go down there because we know what that road going to do. We know who we are. You know, we know who we are. So let's not try to go down that road. There's other options and other resolve that, you know, we can put in place so that we don't have to go down that road.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we have to be aware of it, of course, you know. That's experience.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And we have to just be mindful because nobody, you know, we don't want the vibe and the energy to be fucked up. We here to, you know, create.
Yes. But it's not even that hard to figure it out, though. It's easy. Right. And we just be some, we know we're not supposed to be around this energy and we still be around.
Exactly, though.
Right. Really?
God, I can't wait for that shit.
Well, the energy here is great, Marley. And I appreciate you again coming through and kicking it on the CEO Rural Experience. I know the time goes by fast, but unfortunately, we got to go and pay some more bills. So stay tuned for more of Marley the Great. Stay tuned for more of Ron, a.k.a. Mobile Fun Drinks. And stay tuned for more of the CEO Rural Experience, baby. We'll be right back.
Let's get it.
Hey, girl. Hey, it's the office. It's so indescribable. Yes, so undeniable. I try not to let it show. It just has this certain effect on me. It's that good kind of bad, that sick kind of bad, but that glad kind of bad you and me. How can bad be so good, often misunderstood? For once I don't mind this type of punishment, no, no.
I got it bad, not for your love. That kind of bad,
that's so bad.
But so good to me.
Just let you
say good
go.
Kind of bad, not that sad kind of bad, but that glad kind of bad. You're with me. How can bad be so good, often misunderstood? For once I don't mind this type of punishment. No, no.
I got it bad.
Simple touch of your love, and it makes no sense how you got me out of my element. I got it bad, but it's all good. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Woo!
Hey, girl. Hey.
Do 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 do.
the other.
Hey, we got one. Diving into you, I'm in the deep end. I just move in private, no secret. Let the man ask, treasure, don't leave him. Hop in, press the start, you don't need no key in. Talk to me when I roll up. No good tree when I roll up. Not just me, what's the hold up? I'm a cash cow, watch it unfold up.
Heard good girls love to have fun, and we just came to throw one. So what's up with it? Switch your sweet good gas in my lungs. Heard bad girls love to have fun. So what's up with it?
We gon' throw ones for you, ones for you, ones for you, ones.
We gon' throw ones
for you,
we gon' throw ones
for you.
Babe, what you gon' do for these blue faces? I want you and your friend, is y'all two-faced? One cool, but neck better with two faces. Hennessy and Casamigos, I'm two-wasted. Buy the ball for the bras, send me two cases. If breadsticks was a book, I got a few pages. Papa X and had sex, I'm in a cool matrix. Tell the bartender, send me more ones. Molly in the cut, half fried, half drunk. Hustle, no luck, it's all my denim full of bucks. No dick in your bitch, and she can't get enough. I got the game on lock, no. I heard good girls love to have fun, and we just came to throw one. So what's up with it? Switch your sweet good gas in my lungs. I heard bad girls love to have fun. So what's up with it?
So we gon' throw ones for you, ones for you, ones for you, ones.
We gon' throw ones for you,
ones.
We gon' throw ones
for you. They say money talks, so I've been talking to you lately. Only wanna match my hustle, so I'm highly grateful. Got Chanel on. My favorite fragrance, got Chanel on. Designer in all them placements, red nail polish, them hands in on them toes. Kept it real, kept it solid, stay toast, that's how you show. Like Hovind B, chasing relationship goals. Fine jewelry, got you cozy, here rose gold.
I heard good girls love to have fun, and we just came to throw one. So what's up with it? Switch your sweet good gas in my lungs. Hear bad girls love to have fun, so what's
so
up with it?
Ones for you, ones for you, ones for you.
We gon' throw ones for you.
Ones.
We gon' throw ones for you.
It's that Zone 6 vibe. Zone 6 vibe. Recorded this, yeah. By the way.
She seen diamonds clear as day, just like it's water.
Like it's water.
She just drank that Hennessy, just like it's water.
Just like it's water.
She said I'm horny, stick my tongue out Michael Jordan. We just smoke, drink, sex, then that order.
We just
need to relax, need my peace when I'm recording.
I need my peace.
Hit the drugs, those all just like it's boring.
I need that peace.
She said these niggas way beneath me where the floor is.
Way beneath.
If you don't like it, baby, you know where the door
is. Where the door.
Said I'm good everywhere, and you know this, man.
Know this,
and the
man.
Ones always hate being realest fans. My eyes real low, like I'm from Japan. How does your man's when he expose your man? Look at my neck, look at my wrist, it's all in check. No need to talk a feeling by the check. She say you like the way I'm moving, how I flip. More like paparazzi all on my neck. I just jumped over bitches like it's hopscotch. Cook a crock pot, move it, got the block out. I would not stop, did it on the Harlem shit. Man, I'm dodging cases, man, I caught a break. Never fold a break, never tempt me. Squeeze to the zip, D, I need all black Bentley. But a pecan, every day a weekend. Bring a friend in, maybe she'll tweak then. She seen diamonds clear, they just like it's water. She just drink the Hennessy, just like it's water. She said I'm horny, stick my tongue out Michael Jordan. We just smoke, drink, sex, then that order.
All in that order.
She seen diamonds clear, they just like it's water. She just drink the Hennessy,
just like it's water.
She said I'm horny, stick my tongue out Michael Jordan. We just smoke, drink, sex, then that order.
All in that order.
She seen diamonds clear, they just like it's water. She just drink the Hennessy, just like it's water. She said I'm horny, stick my tongue out Michael Jordan. We just smoke, drink, sex, then that order, yeah.
And we're back with the CEO Row Experience, man. You know you already rocking with the best. Come and enjoy this experience in the flesh.
It's the CEO Row Experience. Today, my guest is Marley the Great, a.k.a. Marsae. You know what I mean? Someone you need to tap in with. Before we proceed, let the people know where they can find you at.
At anywhere worldwide. Mm-hmm. M-A-R-S-A-E. Two underscores.
Go. Two underscores. Not one, but two.
You know what I mean?
I mean, not one, but two. You dig me? Definitely check her out. She's a dope individual. Music is a whole vibe. She's a whole vibe. Again, tap in. It's the last segment of the show. You already know. So in the last segment of the show, I do Finish the Thought. So we're going to start with finish the Thought, and then we'll get into any questions anybody in the studio audience would like to ask. Okay. You dig what I'm saying? So I'll read you a thought, and you go ahead and finish it. Tell me, you know, I'm sure you'll catch on. I know this is weird, but I really like to.
That's going to sound like some fucking freaky shit.
Come on, it's cool. Come on.
Openly sniff the pussy before I eat it.
Okay.
Gotta make sure it's together.
I know this is weird, but I really like to sniff the yams. Sniff the pussy before I eat it.
Make sure
it's
fresh.
Yeah, the kids in bed. The kids is in bed for this, yeah. You already, yeah, that's
that the pheromones.
The pheromones. You gotta, I don't really think, you know, it will be weird to share, I guess, but, you know, it's not weird. Yeah, that's some righteous shit right there. You need to make sure, you know, you steam the yam, steam the vajayjay, keep everything, you know.
Nah, but nice I think she, the way she put it, like, she really be sniffing like a hound dog. Like,
I'm not shy in that way. I'm a person, like, I would literally touch a woman's vagina,
and
I'm going to smell my fucking fingers looking at her, and I'm going to lick my fingers if I want to, if it's right, if it's getting what it's supposed to be. Yeah. All that sneaky, kind of like,
yeah.
Oh, fuck all that dumb ass shit. I'm like, let me see, bitch.
This is too personal. Like, this is too
personal. Hey.
You know what I mean? You get what I'm saying? Like, it's
missing.
Yeah, it's personal. You know what I mean? That's you. So I'll be there anyway, so what difference it make? Why we being shy and bashful for? Understood. Well, we ain't playing with it. I don't play with it.
No
doubt.
No doubt.
Don't play with it.
He probably like,
yeah, I'm good, because I was about to ask another one. When I'm alone, I like to, but you about to give me another drink. So we get it. When I'm alone, I like to.
When I'm alone, it's gonna sound boring.
Okay.
I already said it up. When I'm alone, I really like to ground myself, because I got a lot of shit going on.
Right.
That's complete opposite of sniffing some pussy, but I got to fucking ground myself, because I do a lot of shit.
You gotta stay grounded. That's very important. If things can drive you crazy again, especially when you're doing a lot.
Yeah,
you know, and then you don't want to forget anything.
My phone's just on vibrate all day. I never had my ringer on. I don't know what the ringer is set to. I can't do it because it would be too retarded.
That's funny. I don't want to do it because there's some calls I don't want to miss. But I get a lot of calls too, and people don't be understanding. Like, sometimes,
no.
Depending on what part of the day you call, I might not have got that joint.
But I got to a place where I had to say no to certain things, where I had to give space that can't be so available for everybody.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because then you really stretch yourself thin, and then my dreads will be falling out.
Right.
I only got like five of them and shit.
Accessibility.
You got to set some boundaries.
Yeah, my boundary, my phone is off. So when I'm alone, I like to center myself.
I had to advise and have a deep conversation with a friend of mine about boundaries. Like, you can't, because then you're just making yourself too accessible to everybody. People
can't do that.
Yeah, you can't do that. You got to have boundaries. You got to be able to say, no, I'm not doing that.
Yeah.
You
at a point in time, I had a label. Well, I still have that label, Powerful Music Entertainment, PME.
Shouts out to PME.
And we had 10 artists, excluding me and Dub. So it was 12 of us. And it would be like, Marley, do this. Marley, make this beat. Marley, I need you to mix this song. Oh, I need you to mix a song. Okay, make a radio edit for the song. One of the artists I was working with. Shout out to Eli Beehive. He does like the Snipes commercials and he's all over Power 99 and just not even just Power 99. He's on the airways.
Okay.
He'll just randomly be like, yo, I need you to mix these six songs because they about to play these joints and send me the clean edited radio version. That I'm like, yo, what the fuck, nigga? Like, they just told you right now? Like, what the, like?
And how much time do you got to do that? Like, you know,
yeah,
what
be
I mean?
Short. Like, sometimes, like, eventually it got to the place, like I said, where I had to. Give me fucking more than 10 feet type shit.
Right.
And it was like, okay, let me know in advance. If it's far enough in advance and I don't have nothing planned, sure. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, don't burn me out.
I ain't about to, you know what I mean? So,
right.
That's it. Yeah.
All right. Well, I appreciate you, you know, kicking it with me and being a good sport with Finish the Thought. I would like to get into our audience segment where we allow the audience to come and ask one question. If there's anybody in the audience that would like to ask a question, state your name. And again, you get one question. So if there's anybody that would like to come up and ask a question, you get the opportunity to do so now. Go ahead, you know. Whatever.
The mic, brother. How many drinks you had?
Yeah, it's the mobile fun is. You can stand behind. You can stand behind.
God damn!
You got to get it on you, brother. I know you want to be next to CEO, bro, and Marsae. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's all right.
Cut the mic outside.
Yeah. Cut the mic. Well, yeah, there you go.
Is it on?
Yeah. Is it green?
Okay. All right. My question to you is, from being upstate and expanding with your experience, how did it structure you when it came to your decision making and setting your boundaries from being in a secluded area with a, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And when it come to you doing that, how did that experience structure you to know how to deal with what's going on out here right now?
Like, easy would just be like a short answer would just be, you know, having those, that fake ass structures, this structure type of situation. It allowed me to make better decisions on not going to run down on some shit.
Right.
Or be on a wild ass shit.
Nah, I know.
In a way where it was like, I had to realize those people, I can't be around those motherfuckers no more either. Those same motherfuckers that I didn't have nobody on my list, but they definitely were going to try to come see me anyway. So it really taught me how to look at people and say, okay, it might seem like they cool for this XYZ situation, but, you know, what's external? So really try to get to know motherfuckers. So I'm very selective on who I'm around, right, as well as if it's people that I am around, I really like to get to know motherfuckers. You know what I mean?
Right.
So I was up, you know, you up there with all kinds of characters and people, and they show you one thing, you know, at one point, and, you know, they go around the block, and it's a whole nother situation there on some crazy weird shit. And like I said, my shit was different because I was a lesbian, so these bitches was kind of like weird, trying to like fight to make me the girlfriend type shit. But it was like just seeing the loops that people was doing, I applied that to real life, even down to jobs and shit like that.
Right.
It was like, just, you know, be more observant. I'll say that. It's like, okay, just observe everything. I mean,
yeah. Is there anyone else? State your name.
I'm happy y'all want to ask me questions and shit. I'm like, damn, when you said they're going to ask questions, I'm like, oh shit, they probably don't want to ask shit.
Yeah,
man,
CEO experience. You said I get to know Marsae.
I appreciate that.
No doubt.
Okay. I'm Kelly, a mobile fun girl.
Hey,
how you doing,
Kelly? Right.
My question is for Marsae. You've been playing drums since you were four.
Yes.
At that time, you were playing by ear. Did you go into playing, you know, music with, you know, reading music at some point?
Yeah, I did. When I got into high school, I played in marching band first before jazz. It's crazy because I probably can't read that shit today. That was a long time ago. It was a long time ago. But I'm pretty sure if I sit down back at it, it start making sense again. But yeah, I think learning in church and stuff like that is very much improv, just like jazz. And I mean, so it's expression that helped to be able to not only read music but write music. Because now, like, you got programs where you could, at a push of a button, it could show you.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, what you actually
created.
Yeah. Yeah, and that is the dopest, decentest shit. But you just asking me that make me want to go, you know, look at some shit. Right. You know what I mean? See if I can fuck around and shit. Yeah. But that was a long time ago. But yeah, I definitely did.
Yeah, that's dope now that we have that type of advantage, that now you have the machines and the technology that can read the music for you. And I think that'll help you get a better understanding of how to read and write music.
Hell yeah.
So I think that's very dope. You dig me?
Yeah, I'm old school. We used to have to make the lines.
Yeah.
And actually,
is there anyone else that would like to come up?
They don't got shit like that no more, man. Bring that shit back.
How you doing, everybody? It's Tony Lee. This is a question for the guest, Marsae. I wanted to ask you, in the long run, in the far away future, what are some of your long term goals as far as your things you want to accomplish before you get out of here?
In this incarnation, what I would like to accomplish One of the things I was talking about outside is to create a nonprofit organization, record a studio to teach children audio engineering and music production, because that's not in schools anymore. I mean, it's not around at all. You know what I'm saying? And to buy some fucking resources so we can get these motherfuckers off our goddamn land.
Copy that.
Like, that's really, like, ultimate, like, get these motherfuckers that don't belong on this goddamn land that they got us thinking we from somewhere else in most cases. We not. We from right here. For the most part, for most people. Get them the fuck off our joint. You feel me?
Yeah.
I ain't gonna die until that situation happens. Then I'll go and move on to another community. I'll keep coming back until I get these motherfuckers off our goddamn land.
I appreciate everyone that came up and asked a question. I appreciate everyone that came out to support the show today. All the questions were good questions.
Yes, thank you. I appreciate you.
No doubt. It is a journey. It takes a lot to stay grounded. It takes a lot to stay on course and stay with good energy. We do learn a lot through our journeys. And it's even harder to remember to reiterate it at the time when it's needed, which is the patience and the common sense and the critical thinking. One of the things that I learned through some of my journeys is to understand that we know everything has a consequence, right?
Yeah.
But who had the most control before shit got bad?
You.
Exactly. So it's self-discipline. So at the end of the day, you know, you can't cut corners. You can't make excuses for yourself.
Yeah.
You gotta, if you know it needs to be done, do it. It only is going to hurt you and affect you, because this is your life. This is your book. This is your movie. You know, however you choose to play it, whatever you put into it is what you're going to get out of it.
Facts.
You know what I mean? So you just have to be mindful of what you put yourself in, what situations you put yourself into. Because another thing is, if I don't sell drugs, why would I be getting locked up for drugs if I'm not using them or selling them? You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, I'm not going to be in any environment or hanging with anyone that's associated with that lifestyle. So I don't have to worry about that shit.
Yeah.
My risk of having to run into the law or put myself in a situation where I can meet with the law to go through that is very slim.
Yeah.
You know? And then it's only really comes down to if I have to really defend myself or my family.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, you know, we have to make sound decisions, and we have to also, you know, be mindful of what we put ourselves into.
Yeah.
Why would I deal with this person if I know that before I've dealt with this person, it wasn't a good situation? This person's not accountable. We back and forth.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? It's a stressed out situation. And I mean, okay, we understand people change, but you would have to show me first.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? I'm going to hold you accountable based off of what you show me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? If you say you're a good person and this, you're supportive, then that's what I'll see. It won't be more or less of what you say.
Exactly.
It'll be more or less of what I see you do. Mm-hmm. And in this game, integrity means everything.
Mm-hmm.
You know, again, a lot of times people will come around and they'll come on and they'll preach, oh, I do this, oh, I do that. But number one, nobody asked you.
Yeah.
You know, real rap, nobody asked you what it is that you do. Number two, you're too quick to boast about it because you hot in some shit. Your shit stink just like everybody else, man. There's things that you do that, you know, and again, this is no shot to nobody directly. Yeah. This is a general statement.
Yeah.
Be straight across the board.
Yeah.
Integrity, being straight across the board. If this is what you out here preaching, if this is out here what you telling the people, this is how I walk and this is my whole movement, make sure you keep it thorough across the board.
Be that.
You know, don't say, okay, I do it for these three people, but for those two or one person over there, I ain't fucking with them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, who are you? We haven't all made it.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, we all can touch each other and still be accessible to each other. You feel what I'm saying? So we have to, you know, again, just be mindful, man, of this, what, you know, the situations you put yourself into. And remain accountable, and integrity is everything.
And I say, like, meet people where they at. Cause a lot of times people meet motherfuckers and it's like, you know, the person might have not, you know, got to a certain place, but you might have to meet them at that point in time so y'all both can grow with each other.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like,
I believe in that 100%. It's crazy you say that, Marsae. Because that's what the platform is about. That's what we're trying to show, and that's what we're trying to implement, is that we could come together. These different brands, these different companies, us as people, we can come together and we can give you an experience.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying? We can coexist. We can make it happen. We can make money together. We can build together. You dig me? We can show you something different than what you say that you're not getting. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We're putting it in your face, and we're continuing to give it to you, whether you like it or not. Hopefully, you know, you understand one day and you lock in, and then you'll get all the gems in which we're you know, what we're providing. Mm-hmm. You know, that's what we aim to do. We're not trying to burn down bridges. We try and build them.
Exactly.
You feel me? So, it's, you know,
that's
we're
the
not,
key.
It's the thing is, we're not trying to count anybody out. We're not trying to say we're not willing to deal with anybody. We just want you to, when you, we do deal with you, or if we deal with each other, to come correct.
Yeah.
So that we can officially make it happen.
Yep.
You know what I mean? Nobody's bigger than nobody. Again, you're accessible. I can touch you. I can reach out to you. I can get to you. You know what I mean? Whether you want to deal with me or not. You know what I mean? So, you know, just be mindful, man. And again, you know, love and respect and honor, you know, each other. You dig me? And get back to the love, like you said earlier.
Got to, man. That's the highest frequency, yep.
No doubt. No doubt. Love, and again, I appreciate you coming on. Again, let the people know where they can find you at.
Yes. Marsae, 2 underscores worldwide.
Worldwide.
All platforms, streaming wise, I'm everywhere. I mean, wherever you listen to music at, my music is there.
No doubt, no doubt.
Except for SoundCloud.
Except for SoundCloud?
Yeah.
SoundCloud's kind of whack now.
It served its purpose at a certain time.
I guess.
And everybody else stole from it. And
right. Nettie. Copy that. Made it better, no doubt. And of course, man, I got my guy Ron, aka Mobile Fun Drinks. He put the fun back in the drinks, man, and he made it mobile. Let them know where they can find you at, baby.
You can find me on all major platforms at Mobile Fun Drinks. I'm a phone call away at 267-826-5937. All right, Monday and Wednesday on the CEO World Experience, 7 p.m. to 9.
Yeah, no doubt, baby. I appreciate you, man. You already know how we get
me,
it.
Man.
You already know.
Yeah,
again, if you would like to be on a CEO Row Experience, you can DM me at CEO RO Experience on IG. If you would like to promote or advertise your music or your business on the CEO Row Experience, you can DM me at CEO RO Experience on IG. Again, we welcome all, man. I got conversation for everybody, man. If it's a reason, you know, I'd even be so much man enough to say if it's something you don't like, I'm willing to have you come on my show. We could talk about it. Let's see if we can sway how you may feel about me at the end of the day. You dig what I'm saying? If not, so be it. You know what I mean? I wish you the best. We're going to keep doing the best that we could do over here. And then, you know, I was going to say until next time, you know, take care of each other, man. Peace and love.
Yeah.
Stay tuned.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Don't go anywhere. Hey. Don't go anywhere. We're going to have a performance by my special guest, Marsae, a.k.a. Marley the Great.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we'll be right back. She'll be performing Brainstorm, correct?
Yes.
Yes, that's my favorite.
Yes, sir.
As of late, should I say. So let's go, baby. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Let's get it.
Right.
Marley the Great here. You tuned in to the CEO Row Experience. I am Marsae, and we about to jump into this.
Yeah. Boy, it's hard not to smell me. I'm the shit of Dane. Shit you could tell me. Catch me in a cypher or somewhere at the LB. Or slide through my city with a chick ass fat as Buffy's. Slaying all these vampire rappers, they call me Buffy. Blood sucking leeches, hoping I don't amount to nothing. Hoping I fall or plummet. But I'm the dyke that mold the water, mold the boat the water. Ask your shorty, did she show you what I taught? I got her twirlies on the beam like she a ballerina. Said I'm the woman of her dreams, I told her keep on dreaming. Girl, I'm only on a mission. Greatness in my vision. Tom Brady, my precision. The throne is my position. See, I've been summoned to restore the order. Thanks for your patience, like waitress taking the order. But pie, I need that work right now. Better yet, I order. I call my nigga Ray and tell him meet you at the border. Going back to the future, tell my past thank me in advance. Tell the labels pay me in bonuses, they can keep the advance. Return on my investment is myself. I see nobody but myself. I'm investing in my health. Playing the hand that I was dealt. Champion shit, I got the belt. No brag, it's just honest. I see the future like Nostradamus. Philosophical shit like a Plato. God shit, you see the halo. I'ma go and stop a sorbet shit. I'ma wait for stepping with P and me, cooking shit, got the recipe. Calling shots with a referee. Hit the ball, open sesame. Making magic with alchemy. Shout out to all who doubted me. The glow up on a million. Hustle hard till I got a billion. Parlez vous français, I say oui. When I'm in France, speaking the language of love. My love language is love. Give it back just because. Tipping the eye just because. The time is ours every minute, every hour. I'm eating meats, watch me devour till it's all gone. Words strike like lightning from this brainstorm. Till there's nothing left to say but P and me.
cost to be the boss. Paid the cost to be the boss. I paid the cost to be the boss. Look at me, you know what to see.